Hello and welcome back. You've been listening to the course on professional website development using Joomla 2.5. This is lesson 4, and in this lesson you will learn how to format images for a Joomla website. Alright, so the agenda is we will do image formatting, which includes changing size. Then we will learn how to write text on images. Finally, we will learn how to embed hyperlink on images. Alright, so for doing this, I think we need to have some kind of software to do it. So as far as formatting images are concerned, there are a number of freewares available these days that you can use it. And in order to find out which software to use, I would probably recommend you to Google search and find a good one to use it. But as far as I'm concerned, I'm using Adobe. So let me just show you how image formatting is done in Adobe. Okay, it's Adobe CS6 suite, which is what I'm using it. Now hold on, yeah, that's the one. So this is called as Adobe Fireworks. That's what I'm using it for, my image formatting. In order to format your image, you need to first have your image already downloaded. I've got a couple of images downloaded already. So what I'll do it is, let me just open it. And this image, okay, let's say this image, I open it. If you see, this is a very big image, okay. Now I want to reduce the size of this image. Can you see that? This is such a big image. I want to reduce the size of this image. How do I do it? For doing this, very easy way is modify, then I go to canvas, go to image size. I want to reduce the size of this image to just 218 pixels, you know. So automatically, since it's got constrained proportions, so it automatically sets rest of the proportions because of this property. Okay, you don't have to set all the other proportions. So I've simply changed 218, it changed to 179, the height of the image. If I want to make it even larger, if I change that, it'll automatically, if you see, it's changing the other coordinates. So for the moment, for our demonstration, I want to simply make an image of 218. Okay, once you do that, you simply hit on the OK button and look, the image has become smaller now. All right. So I save this image. What I do it is, I think it's better I save as the image, because I don't want to modify the original image. I save it as, say, something called as carrier advice. Okay. Yeah. So save it as carrier advice and save it out here. Then you can go back to your images and see that particular image. So if you see out here, carrier advice is over here. It's a small one. Okay, so it's just opened it. Now the other thing, okay, let's go back to the presentation. Writing text on images. Now what I want to do it is, let me show you two things. First is, I want to make another image. I want to write text on another image, okay. So for doing that, I will open another image. So I say file, open, and I choose this image, okay. And then how I want to do it is, I want to transpose this image on another image and write some kind of a text, okay. So in order to do that, I want to make a new image, totally a new image. So for making a new image, it's very easy in this software. Say file, new. Okay, it's 218 by 218 coordinates already set up. I want to make 218 size square for three images. Okay, now what I do it is, I take this image and let me just see what's the coordinates of this image are. The coordinates are 109. which I believe is a little bit smaller for my requirement. So I make it say 150. How about that? Okay, so now it's slightly bigger. What I'll do now is I will simply copy this image. Say first you need to select this image. Okay, hold on. Okay, this image is not selected. Say Control and A, by that the image gets selected. Then say image copy. Okay, then come to this new one and here I say edit and paste. When I paste it, okay, it's asking me something. I say resample. So by that the image is pasted now. Okay, now what I want to write out here, if you see, I want to write something on top of it. So in order to write it, I simply hit the text tool and I write it. So I want to write as free Oracle online training, something like this. Okay, so you have to be a little creative to make it catchy. So let's try with this, and now and then what you can do it is you can format the text. So select it, select the text, and then at the bottom of it you can see a number of things out there. So I'll make it bold. You can change the image, say Arial, if you say, then the look and feel of image gets changed. I want to highlight this image and make it a little bigger, so you can change the size of the image. If you see now, it's become a little bigger, and that's exactly what I wanted. Once you do that, then you need to move this text such that it comes in the middle. So hit the control button, and then on top of it, that's that rectangle, simply, you know, pull it like this. So by that, and then what I do it is make it like this, and then I will say I want to justify this image, so it should be in the middle, something like this. Hey, what's happened? Let me justify this one by one, and then this one, right? Okay, so that's what I wanted. I simply wanted to say, okay, free Oracle training and online training it is, and simply highlight a logo out there. So having said that, remember these coordinates. So it's Arial regular 28 is the font size I've used it. So by that I will simply save it. Now I will save it as free Oracle online training. Okay, now you've got two images, right? So let me just close this. I don't need it anymore. Say no. So you've got two images, you've got a career advice. Now on top of this I want to write something, you know, so that it's visible. So again, you can simply use it here and you can write it, say career, or I should say free career advice. Okay, something like this. All right. Now again, it's up to you how you want to do it. This is only for demonstration, how you use text on top of your images. Okay, so move a little further. Okay, then you can see. So this is free career advice, I would say. Then I save this. So I've got two images now. The third image I want to use it is, I say file and new. And then again I set this as 208 as my coordinates. say OK. And this time I want to say free Joomla training. Okay. So I say this free Joomla, I should say online training. Okay. Free Joomla online training. I place it in the middle of the page. If you see this. Okay. Easy peasy, is it not? So by that, let me just save this and then save it as free Joomla online training and save it. So by that I've got three images, and this is what I'm planning to use it as per my specifications. So if I go back to my specifications, what I wanted to use was two images. So let me just go and see. Yeah, here it is. So what I wanted to use was, I wanted to use, look at this, one picture out here and then write some text, then one picture out here, one image, and then write some text about Joomla. So that's what I want to write. Now let's go back to the presentation. The third point is embedding hyperlink on images. Now this point, you can't do that. You may be able to do it over here, but the easier way is to do it in Joomla itself. So let's go to Joomla. Let me just save this. Sorry. So let's go to Joomla. Now before I go to Joomla, I'll go to Google and I'll tell you there are an n number of other imaging software that are there. Okay. So I say, if you say image or free image formatting and simply Google, you'll find a lot of image formatting tools. So you don't have to rely on Adobe CS6 Suite, and that's again your option. I would say that's the best, but assuming that if you don't want to buy that, then you can look for some free tools out here. Look at this, there is one free tool and it's got some 5 words, or you can search. So whichever you feel, you can search and research this online and find a good tool that you can use it for formatting images. Alright, so close this and then I come back to this. Now let's go to Joomla. In this, what I do it is, this is my Joomla backend. Okay, let me see if I'm still logged in. I'm not. So login into Joomla. Hit login. Alright, so we are at the articles. Now if you say new, and yeah, before we go into this, I remember something. What you need to do it is, these images that you just made it, so 1, 2, and where is the third one? Oh, this one. These three images, let me just copy it. It should be in the images directory in your Joomla installation. Only then you can use it in Joomla. Okay, so in order to place that in the images directory, you need to go to the place where you installed Joomla. So remember where you installed Joomla? It was in C drive, XMap, HTDocs, and then that's the folder you have given it for your website. So in my case, I've given the folder name as freeoracletrainings.com. Okay, now you need to go to the folder. If you see out here, images, did you see that? So click on this folder and then simply paste your images here. So in order not to confuse with other images, I would recommend you to make a new folder here, and I say main page. Well, let me write everything in small. Main page images. So this is like, you know, you can clearly identify your images and you don't have to struggle with many images that are lying there. Okay, so if you see three images out here, and where are these images? It's lying under this folder. Okay, images, main page images. Now go back to Joomla backend, and that's where you can use your images. So let me just give this article name as test. Of course, I will explain you in detail about articles in our next class, but here I'm simply showing you how to embed an image in an article. So we have got JC editor over here. Simply enlarge this, and now all you need to do is embed an image. So if you see out here, there is an icon. Did you see that? Let me just enlarge it and show you on top. Yeah, this one. Did you see that? That's the one for images. If you click on that, look, this is what comes up. Okay, so click on that, and then this is where you can use your images, and by default it goes and looks into the images folder, the one where we have simply pasted our images. So that's what are the images we have just pasted, right? Double click on that, it'll open, and then you can choose the images. So say for example I say career advice, okay, and then you have to hit the OK button and slightly down. Okay, let me just get rid of these things, hold on. And then one more. Still not there. Let me just get rid of one more, okay? Menu bar. Wow. Okay, I say view full screen. Yeah, now I got it. Okay, but this time you have to simply hit the insert. So hit the insert, and that's your image. Okay, now if you want to make a hyperlink on top of this image, all you have to do it is click on this link from the toolbar. Did you see that? Let me just show you. Look, this link. If you click on this link, it will ask you for a hyperlink. Okay, look, that's the URL. So what I do it is, say just for testing purposes, I say http://www.aclnz.com. okay, simply type this, and then I say and then I say open in a new window, and then title is career advice. Okay, just for demonstration. Okay, once you're done with that, then you can write some text out here. So I will do one thing is, in this, for this class, I think I simply wanted to demonstrate you how to go about embedding an image in an article and then linking it to through an hyperlink. Okay, so with that, let's go back to our presentation. So by that, it completes the agenda of this class. We have learned how to format image, change size, write text on images, and then embedding hyperlink on images. It's very easy, is it not? So I think by that we have reached the end of this class. So my next class, I will explain you the details about how to use images on articles, how to actually create and publish article, the entire process flow I will show you. Okay, so just stay tuned in, and I will show you in a while. So thank you very much for watching, and goodbye.